Good morning, judges, my dear colleagues. I'm going to present a rare case report of Behçet's disease. So I've given a topic of skin solve the mystery of an eye. So we'll just go ahead with the case. The patient is a 13-year-old female who presented with sudden onset diminution of vision in left eye more than right eye for past 10 days. And it was associated with redness, mild pain, photophobia, and pudendal discharge. And there was also swelling of both the eyelids. So history of present illness goes, patient was apparently asymptomatic 10 days back when she noticed sudden onset pain, redness, discharge, and diminution of vision of left eye. And after 3 days, she was complaining of similar symptoms in the right eye. And she also noticed that she had some painful ulcers over the finger, foot, scalp, oral cavity, and genitals on the third day. So she consulted outside in the private hospital, and there they have diagnosed her with acute mucopurulent conjunctivitis, and they have given a diagnosis of gonococcal conjunctivitis, and they started her on topical fortified antibiotics as cefazolin and amikacin eye drops. But there was no response noticed, so she came to RPC for further management. So on further probing, we took a history of a fever or any systemic illness, but she denied any history of fever. There was no similar complaints in the past. There was no history of any ocular trauma. There was no history of any drug or food allergy. There was no history of any vascular events or any deep vein thrombosis in the past. She was not complaining of any hematuria or any blood in stools or bleeding from nose. No history of consanguinity was there in the family. And there was no similar complaints in the family. She had 3 elder siblings, and all were fine. There was no similar complaints in the family. And she has not attended Menarche till now. Coming to systemic examination, patient was conscious, cooperative, oriented to time, place, and person. And on systemic examination, we saw that there were multiple well-defined ulcerated skin lesions with clear margins, which was noticed over fingers, dorsum of foot, scalp, oral cavity, and perineal area. And mild discharge were also present. Other systemic examinations, such as cardiovascular, respiratory, central nervous system, and GI examinations were normal. So this was the clinical picture. Here we can see she had one oral aphthous ulcer over the tongue. And she was also having angular stomatitis. Here we can see an ulcerated lesion on the scalp, that is back of the neck. And crusting was also there over it. This was a lesion which was present over the finger with clear margins. And this was the lesion which was present on the dorsum of the foot. Now coming to ocular examination, her uncorrected visual acuity in right eye was 6/12, which improved with refraction to 6/9 with -1.25 sphere and -0.25 cylinder at 90 degree. Intraocular pressure on NCT was 18 millimeters of mercury. And eyelids, we saw marked edema was there with matting of eyelashes. There was no entropion or ectropion. Conjunctiva was diffusely congested, and it was boggy in nature, and mucopurulent discharge was there. After clearing the discharge, we could visualize the cornea, and we could see that it was normal in shape and size, and surface was regular, and sensations were also normal. There was no scarring. Coming to examination of left eye, visual acuity was hand movements close to face, and projection of rays were accurate in all 4 quadrants. For other examination, similar findings were there in the left eye as well, but she was not very cooperative for examination. And so we had to take the child for examination under general anesthesia. This was the presentation when she presented to us. So here we can see mucopurulent discharge is there, and conjunctiva is also appearing boggy. And when she has opened her eyes, we could hardly see cornea. So after clearing the discharge, this is the picture of the right eye. And this was the left eye. In left eye, it was very difficult to remove the discharge. It was very much adherent to the conjunctiva, and a simplifron like picture was there in the nasal area. So other examinations were of right eye were within normal limit. Fundus was also normal. There was no evidence of any vasculitis, but we could not examine the left eye. So we took the patient for EUA, and this is the EUA picture. So inferiorly is the superior part, and this is the inferior part. So here we can see, this is the, there was 360 degree of scleral necrosis was there with avascular zone. And here around 7 to 9 o'clock, there was a necrotic area with uveal tissue prolapse was present. And 360 degree peripheral ulcerative keratitis was present. So we sent certain investigations to dermatology and rheumatology, and they have advised a list of investigations. ultrasound was normal, and conjunctiva for microbiology we had sent for both gram staining, fungal culture. Everything was normal, no growth was seen, and on systemic examination also most of the investigations were normal. Chest X-ray was also normal for syphilis investigations, was also normal, and viral serology markers were also non-reactive. Other investigation also we did not find much. ANA, RA factor, ANCA was negative, and HLA profile was also negative. Dermatology, they had advised for pathology test, which also came for negative. So treatment was started. From dermatology, they had started Dapsone 50 mg OD and prednisolone was started 20 mg OD. And rheumatology people, they were suspecting vasculitis sequelae, so they told to start immunosuppressants, and they added azathioprine 25 mg OD. And for local application, they had given Candid cream, and blood investigations were closely monitored as the child was subjected to immunosuppressives. And for eye, we did a scleral patch graft with AMG in the left eye. And on fourth day post-op, we noticed that there was a small lesion appearing in the right eye also. And
I'm so sorry, Pooja ma'am, but kindly wrap up in next 30 seconds. We are up with the time.
Okay, so this is the clinical picture of left eye. And here we can see after starting the topical steroids, the lesion has cleared. And we can see the systemic lesions also has started disappearing. So our diagnosis was Behçet's based on this criteria, which is international criteria for Behçet's disease. So here criteria are given based on genital ethesulcer, scores are being given. So based on this criteria, our score was 6/8, which was diagnostic of Behçet's criteria. Here they say 3 or more points give for diagnosis of Behçet's disease. So there are certain review literature. So here in pediatric patient, mostly panuveitis and anterior uveitis is more common, but our patient was presented with PUK. So take home message is that this case is reported due to positive of data on bilateral presentation of PUK with Behçet's in a pediatric patient. And Behçet's disease is a multifactorial disease which can affect most organ systems of the body with unusual presentation. And multidisciplinary approach is required for precise diagnosis and management of these cases.